Hi, I'm Rick Emerson. Today, to paraphrase Mr. Rod Serling, we will talk about the passion for the printed page. Author Kevin Sampsell joins us, and Outlook Portland begins right now on Northwest 32 TV. Hi, I'm Rick Emerson, and welcome to Outlook Portland on Northwest 32 TV. 26 letters, 9 numerals, a smattering of symbols and punctuation marks. These are, by and large, the tools that make up the English language, be it spoken or written or other. As Keith Richards once remarked about the number of notes on a guitar, there's only so many, but then again, there's really only so many that you ever need. The transmission of thoughts, of experiences, of tales of wonder and merriment, slices of life from both the light and dark sides of human existence, all of these things are made possible by the application of what some people have called the only true telepathy, which is writing. Joining us today, a man who has seen and continues to see the worlds of writing from all of its different angles. His work has been seen via publishers such as McSweeney's and Nerve Magazine. His memoir, A Common Pornography, was published earlier this year, and when he is not busy creating worlds of words, he works among them at Powell's Bookstore. Mr. Kevin Sampsell, welcome to Outlook Portland. Hello, sir.
Thank you very much.
You are from a town called Kennewick, Washington.
Uh-huh.
And Kennewick, Washington, for those who don't know, exists in the shadow of the Hanford nuclear facility. It is dusty, dry, radioactive, probably not terribly interesting. Later on in your life, you wrote a memoir, which we referenced earlier, called A Common Pornography. You talk a lot about experiences from your life, from your childhood growing up, a lot of them drawn from the darker side of life. Mm. Did you have any hesitation about doing that? Did you have a filter of some kind before you told stories that involved real people?
Mm-hmm. Well, a lot of the stories in the book, a lot of the events that happen in the book are things that happened, 20 years or more ago. I don't think I was necessarily negative about a lot of the people I wrote about. My dad, who passed away about 2 years ago, is sort of the one person who kind of gets a bad rap for some of the things he did. But I felt like, talking about these things will sort of help other people who have dark family secrets. And I think even just, after he passed away and some of my family were talking about these things about his life and what he did and things that they didn't know about at the time, I think it just really helped for people in our family to talk about these things.
Did your family know that you were writing this book when you were writing the book, or did you just approach them once the draft was done and say, "Look, I wrote this thing"?
They knew that I was working on it. He passed away in March of 2008, and I think I started working on the book in June of that year. I decided that I wanted to write about it.
Having written a memoir, especially one that deals with sensitive material and things that, I suppose, in certain segments of society, the attitude is that there's things you don't discuss openly, there's things you don't tell, things that you don't tell outside people. When you have discussions with friends now or people close to you, do you sense apprehension, like it's all going into a mental file somewhere for the next book?
No, I don't think so. I don't really write about my friends.
To what extent do you think growing up in a small town, a not tremendously interesting town, contributed to your desire to leave and find something better, either in the world or yourself or both?
Mm-hmm. Well, when I was growing up, I kind of thought that Kennewick, in the Tri-Cities, was a normal place, and I kind of thought it was a nice place to grow up. It wasn't super small, and it wasn't really big and scary or anything. So as I was growing up, I just kind of thought, oh, this is nice. I kind of like that I'm growing up in this environment. I was pretty aware of that. When I got to be 19 or 20, I moved away, and the first place I went to was Spokane. And then I went to Seattle, So I had these ideas in my head that, I'm going to move on to bigger places. And so I kind of took it, you know, a little step by step into bigger towns. But I realized later on that I was kind of bored by the whole small town aspect of it.
I'm going to put a pin in that just for a moment. We come back, we'll talk about your ascension through the ranks of the literary hierarchy and how you came to be sitting on the other side of this table for me. We'll talk about your recent works and where the future takes you. We are talking to Mr. Kevin Sampsell. You are watching Outlook Portland right here on Northwest 32 TV. Stay there. I was be forgetting how to speak there at the end.